Hello and welcome to Cafe Mutual YouTube channel. Friends, Flexi Cap funds have been gaining popularity for quite some time now. In fact, it is second largest category in the equity fund space after large cap funds. To talk about this interesting fund category, we have with us Manish Gunwani, who is CIO Equities at Nippon India Mutual Fund. With over two decades of experience in equity research and fund management, Manish has created wealth for many investors. Welcome, Manish.
Thanks for having me.
So Manish, so the last decade, 2011-21, was quite an eventful for equity markets. So markets across all segments have delivered exceptional returns to investors. So Manish, I would like to understand that what is your view on the current decade, which is 2021 and 2031? And should investors expect current decade to be better than the last one?
So I think the healthy return part hopefully will continue, but I think the nature will change. If you actually look at what has happened in the Indian equity market in the last 10 years, earnings growth has not been very great, right? I think probably in the last 10 years, the Nifty earnings growth will be mid-single digits. A lot of the return has come from select high quality stories which grew rapidly in spite of a slow economy. Even the global economy was mired in a lot of challenges last 10 years. I think hopefully that the next 10 years will be different, because in a sense, the seeds of a boom are laid 5-10 years before that. So I think a lot of the cyclical sectors, a lot of the consumer discretionary sectors which struggled last 10 years, I am quite hopeful that India's growth, the global growth, a lot of the cyclical sectors will do much better next 10 years than last 10 years. Last 10 years was a year of dollar strength after the great financial crisis broadly. The US economy has outperformed, the US dollar has outperformed. Quite likely, I think that next 10 years will be just like 2000 to 2010 was a decade of emerging markets, of non-dollar currencies. I'm quite hopeful that that cycle will play out.
Great. So the next 10 year would be for cyclical?
Cyclical, emerging markets, commodities, that kind of sector.
Great. So Manish, so recently Nippon India has launched Nippon India Flexi Cap Fund. So what is the rationale for this launch?
So the rationale is, see, Flexi Cap category itself is very attractive because it gives you the freedom to go anywhere in the large cap, mid cap, small cap segment. Lot of other categories are constrained. So if we can properly ride the cycles, we've seen that there are 2-3 year phases where either large cap does well or mid cap does well or small cap does well. Last 10 years, broadly 3 phases have happened. Now, any fund which can choose the correct part of these three and stay overweight when that that segment is going well and then switch to another, can obviously generate better outperformance versus the benchmark. Also, the investment universe becomes very big. So you're not restricted that, oh, I've reached a certain limit, I can't buy this mid cap, I can't buy a small cap. Those constraints are obviously not there. So you can look at the entire investment universe. So that way, FlexiCap category itself is quite attractive.
Okay. But Manish, why do you think that it is right time to invest in flexi cap funds, especially when the markets have been trading at their all-time high valuation across capitalization?
So the question is basically why equities and then why flexi cap within equities? So within equities, see, a lot of people today have apprehension on valuation and the performance of the stock market. But both these things, I think we have to see from a 3-5 year perspective, not just what has happened in the last 1 year, because the market fell a lot in March 2020 when COVID happened and have recovered a lot. If you see on a 3-5 year basis, the market is at trend return, a mid-teen kind of return. So it is not very exceptional. The second point is that we are sitting, we believe, at the cusp of a big earning cycle turnaround. So as I said, basically last 10 years, the corporate earnings have not done all that well with mid-single digit kind of growth when nominal GDP was actually growing faster. So I think there were various reasons which all are now turning around. So we believe that next 3-4 years in particular will be very strong for corporate earnings. And also the interest rates, I think globally, are being held at a very low rate by the central banks. That is a reality we have to accept, because theoretically, if interest rates are lower on a structural basis, then equity valuations will remain high because the discounting rate reduces. And your alternative investments, which is fixed income, real estate, etc., they are obviously not looking like producing any great returns. So given this context, we believe that while on a price to earning multiple, the markets are at high valuation, but the narrative about equity market today is earning yield less bond yield, and bond yields are obviously low. The earning cycle is looking strong. So we think the equity on 3-4 year basis can compound steadily.
So how comfortable are you with the valuations in the market currently?
So as I said, if you just go by history, yes, the price to earning multiple is high. Mm-hmm. But today, globally, if you see, even the most developed countries, the equity valuation is seen more in relation to bond yields rather than just looking at equity valuation. So if you look at it that way, in India, we are somewhere in the middle. Also, when we are looking at a corporate earnings cycle turning around, the simple point is over next 3-4 years, if corporate earnings can grow at high teen kind of CAGR, then it is unlikely that the market will give very disappointing returns, because even if the price to earning multiple were to trend down, the fact that earnings is growing at high teens will ensure that we get a steady compounding return.
Okay. So Manish, we have seen that many investors end up buying large cap company in a regular flexi cap portfolio.
Yeah.
So in fact, SEBI has acknowledged this fact and introduced multi cap funds. So what is your comment on this?
So you're correct that one of the ways in which we think our FlexiCap fund will be different will be that over a cycle, we will have more of mid and small cap companies than what is there in the category today. So we think that over a cycle, we will probably be around 50% in mid and small cap. Now, obviously, when mid and small cap becomes very expensive, like 2017, we will obviously have more of large caps. This is obviously thoda with the benefit of hindsight. Mm-hmm. But I'm saying we will obviously try to play whichever segment is more attractive. But on an average, I do think that a lot of the flexi cap funds today have more large caps than is desirable. And that is one of the ways we think our fund will be different, that it will have, on an average, more mid and small caps.
So any particular number or any particular figure that you have kept in mind for mid and small cap stocks?
So the way we've defined the guideline for the fund is what we have said, large caps will be deviating by maximum 50% from the large caps in the benchmark. So for example, if large caps in the benchmark are 80%, 50% of that is 40. So it will be 80 plus or minus 40, which technically now is 40 to 100%, let's say. But more importantly, over a cycle, we think broadly 50-50 will be the mix between large cap and mid and small cap. So half will be large cap and half will be mid and small cap on an average.
Okay. So Manish, many MFDs believe that they should go with existing flexi cap funds with a long-term track record. So in such a scenario, why they should recommend, Nippon India FlexiCap NFO to their clients?
So I think more than the scheme, what is important is the entire process of the house, the philosophy of the house, etc. And if you see our fund, especially in the mid and small cap space, they have given good returns both in the short term and the long term. So whether it is a small cap fund or growth fund, which is a mid cap fund, I think they are demonstrating that our research, especially in the mid and small cap space, is quite robust. And therefore, every NFO, obviously, you can say that this is a new fund, what is the track record? But the point is the fund managers have track record, the house has track record. And I think over time, we have demonstrated that all our funds today have done pretty well over last 12 to 15 months. We obviously had funds which were not doing well, but we have been able to improve their performance. We have put in a lot of processes. We have increased the experience and expertise level of our research. So there's been a lot of work going at the back end to improve the delivery of alpha returns. And I think that is the reason investors should look at this NFO.
Okay. So Manish, my last question to you is that many MFDs are currently not comfortable recommending equity funds due to high valuation, of course. So what is your message to them?
So my message to them is, as someone said, there is more money lost by waiting for a correction than the correction itself. So asset allocation is very important. I'm not saying this is a time to increase asset allocation to equities a lot. This is a time where the market, to our mind, will deliver steady compounding returns. And the fact that other alternative investments are not looking great will ensure that equities are very interesting. Please don't look at just one number like price to earning multiple. The corporate earning cycle, to my mind, has bottomed out. The interest rates globally are being held lower structurally. And in that scenario, to go underweight on equities, I don't think is advisable.
Okay. So with that, we have come to an end to this interesting session. Thank you so much, Manish, for your valuable time and insightful nuggets. Thank you so much.
Thank you.